Chapter 05, Building the Rock Shoulder. Everyone wants to have the rock shoulder in washboard abs. These are the aesthetic muscles that make you look good with or without clothes. First, let's start off with the rock shoulders. Some even call it the diamond delts and even the boulders. Whatever you call it, round, rock solid and striated shoulders are highly sought after by anyone who are into fitness. So how do you get the rock shoulder? Essentially, there are three angles you need to tackle to have round, solid deltoids or delts, which are front delts, middle delts, and rear delts. Here are my simplified and complete workouts to fully engage every angle of your delts and making them pop. 1. Lateral shoulder raise. 2. Standing side deltoid circle raise. 3. Seated overhead military press. 4. Seated alternated dumbbell press. 5. Upright rowing. 6. Seated bent over rear deltoid raise. 1. Lateral shoulder raise. Lateral shoulder raise, the best lateral deltoid exercise in history. This is the best exercise to sculpt round shoulders and giving others the impression of you having huge and wide shoulders. 1. Position the height of the seat so that the feet are firmly planted on the floor. This gives resistance against the floor and assists in balance and stability while lifting. The seat should be adjusted to a comfortable position to perform the movement. 2. Depends on the type equipment you use, whether it's dumbbell or lateral raise machine, you either place the forearms against the pads or grip the handles. Start with your arms at your sides. 3. If you're using a machine, raise the arms up while pushing against the forearm pads. If you're using dumbbells, simply raise those dumbbells laterally. 2. Standing side deltoid circle raise. Standing side deltoid circle raise, one of the best exercise for overall shoulder muscles development in all different angles. 1. Pick up the weights with your palms facing each other. Try to use your legs to lift the weight, rather than your back. Keep the back straight and the head up. 2. Stand up straight with your feet positioned in a comfortable stance so you are well balanced and relaxed. The feet should be about shoulder width apart, the arms should be fully extended at your sides with a dumbbell in each hand. 3. You begin with both dumbbells hang on your side. At the same time, raise both dumbbells out to the sides, bringing them up just above shoulder height. It is acceptable to flex the elbows slightly as the weights are brought up. 4. Lower the weights using the same lateral motion with which they were raised. Usually, you can't go heavy on this exercise. So take a light weight and perform 8 to 10 circles of each set of this exercise. 3. Seated overhead military press. Seated overhead military press, a power movement to develop the mid-deltoids. 1. You can perform military press using dumbbells, kettlebells or barbell. First, make sure to sit upright on a stool. Grasp onto your barbell with shoulder width apart. 2. At the starting position, both of your elbows are tucked in and the bar lay on your upper chest. To execute the movement, simply push the bar upward with your arms fully extended. The bar or dumbbell should be at the overhead position at the top of the lift. 3. One thing you need to make sure is to keep your core tight, spine erect and head held up as you perform the exercise. 4. Finally, lower your weight slowly until it's back to the starting position. You don't want the weight slamming down at you, so make sure you move the weights in a slow, controlled tempo for gains and safety. 4. Seated alternated dumbbell press. Seated alternated dumbbell press, another variation of military press with more control and isolation. 1. Lift two dumbbells in a continuous motion, keeping the back straight and the head up, until they are at shoulder height. 2. Position the feet firmly on the floor and push against the floor for stability. Notice that the heel of the prosthetic leg is pushing against the floor. 3. Keep the elbows out to the sides and the thumbs facing each other. 4. Lift to mid-chest level. 5. Upright rowing. Upright rows, a killer workout for the middle deltoids. 1. First, stand upright with your knees slightly bent to buffer the weights. Then, prepare a set of dumbbells, kettlebells, barbell or as barbell to perform the exercise. 2. To move into the starting position, stand upright with the weights hanging on both sides. 3. Your feet should be shoulder width apart and slightly bent for balance. 4. You should apply overhand grip for this exercise and keep both hands close to each other. From that position, raise the weights upward to your chin in a pulling motion. Imagine carrying 2 pails of water vertically while standing upright. 5. At the top of the lift, the elbows should flare out to the sides and keep them as high as possible. 6. Remember to pause and squeeze at the top of the lift before lowering them back down to the starting position. 7. Repeat the movement until you've completed your desired repetitions. 6. Seated bent over rear deltoid raise. This workout targets the rear delts, a part where most people neglect but essential to bring out the round boulders. Here's how you do it. 1. Select 2 lightweight dumbbells, 10 pounds or less for the beginner. Place them on the floor on either side of the end of a flat bench. 2. Sit at the end of the bench with your feet fairly close together and planted firmly on the floor. The dumbbells should be on either side below where you are sitting. 3. Lean forward so that your chest almost touches your thighs. Keep your head facing the floor. Lift the dumbbells to the height of your ears. 4. Raise the dumbbells out and upward, straightening your arms and locking the elbows. 5. Lower and raise the dumbbells in a continuous semicircular motion, keeping your arms straight and elbows locked. 6. Inhale as the dumbbells are raised, exhale as they are lowered. You don't have to go heavy for this exercise, as the rear delts are not huge muscles. Try doing it for 12 to 15 reps each set with control for best results. How to get washboard abs? Are you slumping in the couch right now? With your tummy bulging from beneath your shirt? Fatty, one pack, beer belly, are you sick and tired of these words? Or have you been suffering from being overly skinny and bony, that it makes you feel small, weak and vulnerable? Abs is a short form for abdominal, which is your stomach muscles. A well-developed rectus abdominis or six-pack abs, seems to be the end goal of any exercise regimen. It is this muscle group that is one of the most challenging to build, as tons of effort and brutally intense workout do not magically guarantee a successful outcome. Think of your abs as a byproduct, not a muscle that you build. Like a bonus of work from a job well done. But if you aim for overall well-being first and six-pack abs second, you are more likely to keep up the vigorous training needed to get that enviable perfect physique. The solid foundation to get washboard abs. 1. Burn your fats first. Want to burn those unwanted fats? Perform some regular aerobic activity. You can't spot reduce abdominal fat. You need to burn your overall body fat before your body allows you to start building specific muscle group. Cycling, jogging, running, jumping rope, and swimming are some good aerobic exercises to achieve this. To enable your body to begin burning your stored fat, you should blast fat for at least 30 minutes by performing heart rate elevating exercises. This is because your body only burns energy from food during the first 20 minutes. The ideal calculation is 30 minutes for at least 4 times a week. It is best done before breakfast as it triggers your body to burn your previously stored fats. 2. Crunches exercise. Tone your abs with crunches. There are 3 types of crunches to target specific region of your abdominal area to achieve an evenly sculptured washboard abs. Regular crunches, stones upper abdomen. 1. Find a place with a solid support for your back. Lie on an exercise mat to prevent straining your back. 2. Your knees should be bent. Your feet position should be as wide as your hips and both should be flat on the floor. Your hands should be behind your head. Hold your chin forward, not tucked into your chest. Try to gaze at ceiling while you're doing this workout to ensure your chin is in the right, safe position. 3. Exhale. Contract your abs muscle. Use your abs muscle to lift your head. Do not pull your head up with your hands. 4. Pause for a moment. Squeezing your abdominal muscle as you do so, then inhale slowly and ease your back down the starting position. You must control your movement while lifting your back up and going back down. Do not release and let go rapidly. 5. Relax your muscles for a moment, exhale and repeat. Throughout the exercise, be mindful to keep your knees bent and your feet in the same position. Never lift your lower back off the floor. Reverse crunches, tones lower abdomen. 1. Similar to the regular crunch, your hands are behind your head, your shoulders off the floor, but this time you are going to have knees in the air to start the movement. 2. With your feet and knees up, pull your knees as close as you can and hold that position. From there just go back and forth 3. A good reverse crunch that targets the lower abs would be a small movement 4. Each crunch needs to be a squeeze and not a rocking motion 5. Don't let your upper body move too much. 6. Repeat for several times. Bicycle crunches, tones obliques, aka love handles, 1. Find a place with a solid support for your back. 2. You can support your hands behind your head to make sure you are not yanking on your neck. This may cause pain and problems. You are just supporting your head. 3. Keep your shoulder blades off the ground. Bring knees up to 90 degrees. Bring your right elbow to left knee as you alternate side to side. Your goal is to get your elbow as close to the inside of that knee as you can 4. Now simultaneously, slowly go through a cycling motion 5. Continue alternating in this manner. 6. Bear in mind that it is essential that you increase the difficulty of your exercises and change the variety of your workout routines every 2 months. This is to allow your muscle to recuperate and burn calories efficiently. Do these routines at least 3 times a week. Remember that crunches are best done very slowly and always with control. 3. Eat smart. Avoid processed foods, at all means if you can. Foods that have undergone preservation or packing have lost their nutrients. And worse, processing adds on unhealthy fats, plenty of sugar or a sugar substitute, and synthetic vitamins and minerals. Most of the ingredients in processed foods include sweeteners, coloring, and hydrogenated oils. These ingredients are not even recognized by your body as edible ingredients, so they end up being stored as fats. 4. Eat healthy fats. Fats have a bad reputation, but not all fats are harmful. Dietary fats coming from monounsaturated and polyunsaturated fats are food for you. Olive oils, fish oils, natural peanut butter, avocado, and almonds are some really good examples. Just make sure to keep your intake between 20% and 30% to regulate your calories. This will help stabilize your insulin level, which if too high, causes fat retention. By eating healthy fats, you are more likely to stay away from the fridge looking for food, as these healthy fats tend to keep you sated for a longer time. Most often, eating only protein or carbs alone will make you hungry more often. 5. Drink plenty of water. Studies have shown that people who drink a lot of water lose more weight and are able to keep it off longer. Adequate water intake boosts your metabolism rate. Drinking more water helps you stay away from empty calorie drinks like soda and processed juice. 6. Eat good carbs. Good carbs like whole grains are rich in fiber and go through your system much slower than refined, white carbs. Therefore, it avoids spikes in blood sugar levels. Instead of your normal to-go carbs, always opt for healthy carbs, whole grains, nuts, pumpkin, potatoes. 7. Eat protein for breakfast. What's more important than filling your tummy with protein early in the morning? A protein-packed breakfast is closely related to increased feelings of fullness, and this would help to reduce your desire to snack. For example, instead of the usual ham and eggs, maybe you can go for nuts, egg whites, and cottage cheese. Eat less but often. Rather than eating 3 big meals per day, you can eat 5 meals per day, but each with a smaller portion. When your body is hungry, it likes to hoard fat, causing you to crave foods like pizza, burgers, and pastries. If you're rarely hungry, your metabolism learns to stabilize, and you won't feel food cravings. If you would like to try a stricter diet to keep your blood sugar level balanced throughout the day, eat 4 to 5 proper meals in bite-sized portions. You tend to not overeat this way, because you'll be consuming foods high in fiber, protein and nutrients. We've just unlocked the secrets to getting washboard abs. It's all about making small lifestyle choices in order to reduce body fat. Eat clean, take it easy on junk food, drink plenty of water, work those abs and do cardio. Abs are yours for the taking. Chapter 06. Celebrity workout. Adding celebrity exercise to your workout plan. Once your diet is all set and you're confident with what you can eat, it's time to put the workout into play. There are various types of workout you can choose, depending on your goals and what you like to do with your personal time. The most significant point is that you need to seek something that you enjoy doing or really want to do. It is not necessary to determine a certain type of workout because it's what you feel you are needed to do. There are various choices. If you think that this type of workout does not appeal to you, you can shift to a different workout. When it comes to celebrity workout plans, they are barely an accurate representation of what the individual actually did. Most celebrity workout plans that you could find on the internet would probably lack information about the individual's nutrition, recovery protocol and prior training history and so on. Most importantly, everyone's physique is built differently. Instead of relying on using a celebrity's ideal physique as a target to desire for, use them as inspiration to stay consistent with your training, diet. Genetics play a significant role in how a person's muscles are developed and shaped, and no amount of workout will change how you are physiologically built. Differences between high, low bicep insertions, performing bicep curls will not change your insertions. Muscle insertion affects all muscle on your body, and biceps are a simple example to illustrate this point. Practicing celebrity workouts personally, you can still follow your desired celebrity workout plan as a stepping stone to achieve your goals of muscle building. But in terms of diet plan, it is not ideal to straight out follow their diet plans, even if it is out there for people to look up to. Our daily caloric needs are varied from individual to another individual. Even if you have the exact same weight and body metabolism, doesn't expect to gain the same results as what they have achieved. Nonetheless, let's look into several celebrity workouts that shape into everyone's desired body. Daniel Craig, famous for his role as the current James Bond 007 agent in the James Bond franchise film, he spent months to tune his body just for this particular role. He took on weight training 5 days a week, followed by light cardio with stretching on the weekends, stayed consistent with the ideal diet plan, and had a personal trainer and dietitian to keep him in line. As he was not overweight prior to engaging in his workout, he just needed to lose a proper amount of weight and build muscles. Generally, most people would concentrate on one muscle group per day, working it only once a week. Daniel worked on full body circuits, boosted his heart rate and developed muscle and endurance at the same time. Daniel Craig physique back in James Bond, Casino Royale, 2006, full body circuit, weekdays, with light cardio, weekends. A full body circuit is a workout that jumps from one exercise to another with minimal rest. This is the optimum way to build muscle and burn fat at the same time. Moreover, it is an effective workout in burning fat than a traditional cardio routine. On the weekdays, he would be doing 10 reps of each exercise and move on to the next exercise and do 10 reps without rest until he completes the circuit. Moreover, he does it in 3 complete sets of the circuit, reducing rest time. The reasoning behind how he was able to conduct the workout back to back is because the workout encompasses various muscle groups. In this manner, your body will not overexert itself. The following is Daniel Craig's workout plan. 1. Monday's workout, power circuit, 10 reps per exercise with 3 sets, clean and press, weighted knee raise, weighted step-ups, pull-ups, incline push-up, triceps dips 2. Tuesday's workout, chest and back, 10 reps per exercise with 4 sets, incline bench press, pull-up, incline push-up, incline pec flies 3. Wednesday's workout, legs 10 reps per exercise with 4 sets, squat, straight leg deadlift, hamstring curl, weighted lunge 4. Thursday's workout, shoulders and arms 10 reps per exercise with 4 sets, incline biceps curls, triceps dips, lateral raises, shoulder press 5. Friday's workout, power circuit, 10 reps per exercise with 3 sets, clean and press, weighted knee raise, weighted step ups, pull up, incline push up, triceps dips 6. Saturday /Sunday's workout, light cardio such as outdoor physical activities. Hugh Jackman, widely known for his long-running roles as the Wolverine in the X-Men film series, as well as various lead roles in movies such as Van Helsing, The Prestige and Les Miserables, which got him nominated for Best Actor for the Academy Award. Before he co-starred his role as the Wolverine, he worked together with his trainer David Kingsbury to get his desired shape for the role as the Wolverine. According to his trainer, he was already in a good shape before proceeded to build up his muscle mass and leanness for his role. Due to that, he focused more on direct strength workout with 1-5 rep followed by higher rep schemes. In order to keep the body percentage low while putting on muscle mass, Hugh Jackman's training mostly consists of both low intensity and high burst, short training intervals. As a result, he was able to maintain his weight while being shredded with visibly more muscle mass. He achieved his ideal results from both dieting and performing high volume of cardio first thing in the morning. So what about the diet? It's actually quite straightforward. On weight training days, he'll consume higher carbs as compared to off days and cardio days. In terms of supplement consumption, while for pre and post workout he took muscle mass and universal L-carnitine acids. Took creatine for bulking BCAAs to preserve lean to help metabolize fatty. Hugh Jackman jumping back into his intensive workout preparing for his upcoming roles in future X-Men sequels. 4 weeks intensive training. Hugh's 4 weeks training focuses on progressive overload and keeps striving for personal best. This routine does not encourage sacrificing strength over size because it incorporates both bodybuilding, high reps, low, medium intensity, and powerlifting styles, low reps, high intensity, of training. This training plan is made up of a 4-week cycle, where you gradually increase the weight each week up to the 3rd week, then drop the heavy weights on week 4 by -50% and perform higher reps instead. The main lifts include barbell bench press, back squat, weighted pull-up, deadlift. Perform the main lifts first during training days, then proceed with accessories workout of your own choice. The general outlook of the training schedule is as follows: week 1 4 sets of 5 reps each week, 2 4 sets of 4 reps each week, 3 4 sets of 3 reps each week, 4 4 sets of 10 reps each. Chris Evans. Almost everyone recognizes Chris as Captain America in the movie Avengers and the Human Torch in Fantastic Four. No, it's not like in the movies where you see Chris took some wonder drug to have the Captain America's badass physique. In fact, Chris gained massive amount muscle mass with an intensive workout routine in order to play the role as seen on the silver screen. His training was mainly focused on resistance training with only minimal cardio, which is about 20 minutes a day. Generally, this workout is suitable to those who have been training for over 6 months consecutively and want to shift towards a different workout plan, resistance training routine to build up muscle mass. It is recommended to consume whey protein drink about an hour before and after a workout for muscle recovery and growth. The workout routine focuses on 4 sets of each exercise and 8 to 10 repetitions. Practice 4 sets of each exercise in a row and take a minute rest between each set and before jumping to the next exercise. Day 1 shoulders, seated barbell press, lateral raises, dumbbell press, seated rear deltoid raise, shrugs, 10-minute heat training session on treadmill or bike. Day 2 chest, flat bench press, incline chest press, bench flies, decline chest press, push-up on Bosu ball. Day 3 legs, barbell squats, leg press, hack squats, lunges, seated calf raises, 10-minute heat training session on treadmill or bike. Day 4 arms and core, barbell bicep curls, skull crushers, incline seated bicep curls, cable hammer curls, dips, close grip bench press, ab crunches with legs raised, 30-second stability ball plank, stability ball jackknife, oblique crunches on stability ball each side. Day 5 back, pull-ups, seated row, lateral pull-downs, stiff leg barbell deadlift, bent over barbell row, 10-minute heat training session on treadmill or bike. Day 6 and 7 rest, body and energy recovery workout plan for beginners. For any beginners that would like to start muscle building, the fastest way to see results is to study how the person with the ideal physique you die for achieved such result and then leverage such knowledge to achieve a similar result. You really don't have to complicate things nor reinvent the wheels. The fitness industry has evolved over the years and there are literally countless workout plans out there created by professionals proven to deliver results. All you need to do is to commit to one and follow through, that's it. Ultimately, there are only 2 biggest goals in fitness: 1. Lose fat. 2. Gain muscles again. You only need to decide which are your biggest goal at the moment, choose a workout plan, block out 30, 60 or 90 days. And finally, commit until you achieve your desired body fat percentage or muscle mass. Chapter 07, Secret Muscle Building Techniques for Vegans. The possibilities of building muscle as a vegan. As long as you are consuming the right nutrition with high protein, you don't have to be a meat eater to build muscles. Building up your muscles is 80% from your diet, while the remainder 20% comes from your physical exercise and training. To lose fat and build muscle, you have to eat correctly. This will be your first and main priority before moving to your physical activities. If you got diet fixed and in check, you are a step closer to building up muscle. That being said, building muscle as a vegetarian is a daunting task and a complex one due to the fact you would have a restriction to the certain food that you have access to eat. Diet plan tip: to build muscle, eat at a surplus and do resistance training. The essential nutrients determining your vegan diet plan is significant to determine on what you can and should eat and how you can consume it. Just like any ordinary people that have fixed their diet plan, as a vegetarian, it is best to track the calories of everything you eat during the entire day. As a vegetarian, your protein requirements will vary from the usual diet plan that ordinary people practice. If you are strength training, then you would probably need to take protein supplement with the addition to your personal diet. There are various types of protein-based foods that you can consume, such as hemp protein, soy, rice protein and gemma protein. Egg or whey protein are viable options too if you are not a vegan that avoid foods produced by animals or animal products in any way. Diet plan tip: when it comes to protein consumption, always be conscious of eating various sources of nutrients for a complete distribution of amino acids. The significance of vegetable protein. There are various significant factors to look into when it comes to the consumption of vegetable protein. Studies show that the anti-nutritional factors which are commonly found in soy and other vegetable protein have negative effects in human nutrition. These are substances or compounds which act to reduce the intake of nutrients, absorption, and utilization and may produce other adverse effects. Hence, it is highly significant to keep in mind that a higher consumption of vegetable protein is required to gain the same effect of a usual consumption of protein. The best vegetable protein powders you could consider are as followed: whey protein, one of the best choices for vegetarians, especially for muscle builders. Moreover, it helps with cutting down excess weight and supports the overall of your health. Whey protein can be easily absorbed and digested into your body. Additionally, it is an ideal choice for people who are lactose intolerant, as it is tolerable compared to other protein powders. If you're a veganism that is refrained from consuming any dairy products, whey protein is clearly not your choice, as it is derived from cheese production. Brown rice protein powder is a good option if you can't opt for whey protein, as they are gluten and dairy free. They are packed with high levels of antioxidants and nutrients to support weight loss. Hemp protein, it contains a complete amino acid profile while it is easy to digest, and it helps with pre-workout as it won't cause stomach issues while you are exercising. Moreover, hemp is a safer plant source of protein in general, as it is cultivated using the organic agricultural method. There are various nutrient-dense foods that you can gain protein for your plant-based diet. Vegetables such as avocado, broccoli, spinach, sweet potatoes and boiled peas can be your staple vegan diet. Legumes, especially lentils and beans, which have been the foundation of various diet plants, is a plant that you could consider. They are high in protein and dietary fiber. Moreover, they are mainly feel-good foods for satiety, balancing blood sugar, maintaining weight and energy. Last but not least, nuts and seeds can be incorporated into your snack or meal diet plan, as they offer high amounts of protein, fiber, vitamins, and minerals. Planning out your diet. Planning out your diet is being self-aware with what you eat and how much you eat daily. The optimized way to do this is to calculate the calories of everything you consume during the course of the entire day with the use of a calorie tracking application or a pen and paper. You can check out https://www.myfitnesspool.com/to-be-used-a-calorie-tracker. To easily estimate on how much you should be eating, you need to determine your own total daily energy expenditure, TDEE. Check out http://www.1percentage.com/folk/, which is a good tool to adjust your calorie intake to match your personal goal, whether that is muscle buildup or fat loss. Suffice to say, if you wish to gain muscle, you basically need to eat over your total daily energy expenditure, TDEE. If you are losing weight at the same time while building muscles, it is best to remain conservative by staying within 500 calories above or below, respectively. The calculator will only project out the estimated daily caloric needs, hence you need to track your daily calorie intake and compare that to your weight loss gain to determine a more personalized approach. Adjust your daily intake and reassess for the next few weeks. Repeat this step until you are losing weight at the motion determined by your own daily deficit. Diet plan tip: the best meal plan is always going to be one that you create yourself. Now that the secret has been revealed, the Great Wall was not built today. Everything takes time to be better, so as your body. As long as you have the determination to carry on, you will definitely taste the sweetness of the fruit by the end of the day. There is no shortcut in building muscle. Taking protein powder is just a supplement to help. It is not everything. As I have mentioned in the previous chapter, excessive intake of protein powder will lead to kidney failure and other horrible side effects. You should never risk your health by rushing your body system to achieve what you desire. Remember, your health is everything. Without healthiness in your life, you are just plain surviving. You are not living it. There is a mere difference between staying alive and living a life. What more can you ask for when you are not able to take a good care of your health? What kind of life do you think you will live without your health? Think about it before you decide to take any shortcuts or any actions.